Thank you, Erwin. Thank you for organizing this this symposium, and it's great to be here. So I'm going to give you an essence of the work that we've been doing in developing instrumentation and approaches for performing speed of sound imaging using laser-induced ultrasound sources. So the context of this work is actually the PAMET project. This is a Horizon 2020 project which I coordinate. And in this project, we've actually set up a sophisticated computer tomography system using photoacoustics for imaging the breast. In the system, we also provide the functionality for doing speed of sound imaging using conventional ultrasound transmission measurements. But at the same time, we are actually also looking at opportunities for laser-induced ultrasound sources. and the work is predominantly done by David Thompson, who's a PhD student in my group, and Damien Gusto, who's a postdoc till last year. So basically in this system, we have an imaging bowl, and the inside of the bowl is actually lined with ultrasound transducers. And in addition, we have optical fibers, which actually lead into the bowl, which are connected to a laser in order to give the light for conventional photoacoustic imaging. And on top of that, we have another set of optical fibers. Only one is shown in blue. And these fibers actually terminate in what I call a laser-induced ultrasound transmitter. Let's call it a LIUS transmitter, because laser-induced ultrasound is well a mouthful. So this fiber leads into, at the distal end, it's sort of all the fibers actually lead into an arrangement. And we have a mechanism by which we can actually couple a compact laser to each of the fibers in turn. And by this, we're actually activating the laser-induced, the LIUS transmitters on the inside of the bowl for speed of sound imaging. So let's go immediately into what such a LIUS transmitter looks like. Here's a photograph and here is a schematic. We have a LIUS absorber, which is mounted onto a segment, which we call the space segment, which in turn is mounted onto what we call a fiber holder segment. So all of these parts are made from clear perspex. And the fiber holder arrangement can actually accommodate a chuck which can be screwed in, and that carries an optical fiber. We use a 600 micrometer fiber, which is a multimodal one. And this entire assembly can actually be fitted with nuts and a screwing arrangement with the help of O-rings to make a watertight seal in the imaging tank. So the light actually comes in, is allowed to expand, and that's why we call it a spacer arrangement. And the light falls on the LIUS absorber. And by this, we can actually try to somehow optimize the spot size and therefore the active area on the LIUS absorber. And we have some handle on the opening angle of the instonifying field in the imaging tank. So the LIUS absorber itself, we are aiming to get about 1 megahertz center frequency of the acoustic field, because this matches very well with the conventional, let's say, piezoelectric detectors that we use in the PAMET bowl. And we've actually done this by using PDMS that is doped with carbon nanoparticles in such a way that you get that center frequency. And this turns out to be a disc of about 2 millimeters in thickness. And we do this by actually casting PDMS and the carbon nanoparticles in a mold. So what does it look like with actual signals? This is the frequency response. We managed to hit that 1 megahertz reasonably well with a multitude of such transmitters. The pressures that we can generate is about 50 kilopascal at 50 millimeters in water with about 1.4 millijoules per pulse. The signals are getting to look better and better, but we are still disturbed by this nuisance of a secondary peak that's really a reflection of the ultrasound signal at the interface between the spacer segment and the next segment and heading back into the imaging bowl. However, this is going to be disaster for reflection mode measurements, but for the transmission mode measurements, we do reasonably well because the algorithm actually does time of flight picking of the first or the leading transient. So we set up a sort of tabletop system to replicate the imaging bowl of the PAMET system, except on its head. So basically we have two wedges that look like that. This is the side view, and these are shown antipodal to each other, but they need not be. They can move actually independently of each other, and so you can synthesize the entire bowl. So one of these, the transmitter wedge has a single, at this point in time, a single transmitter, and the other one has a single detector. So in the ultrasound mode, you can also do photoacoustics, but about the ultrasound mode, we have the transmitter occupying a stationary position for the first set of acquisitions, and we actually move the detector wedge so that the detector is actually sampling the cone beam of the insonifying field. This is only in 2D, I should say. And then we go to a second position of the transmitter and then replicate this acquisition. We set up a phantom, which is based on PVCP, which is pretty big. It's about 80 millimeters in diameter with a couple of cavities in there, which hold water. For the reconstruction, we collaborate with the University of Bern, Michael Yeager and Martin Frenz. And these are the kinds of images that we can get. It looks actually pretty good. We've managed to actually catch the irregularities of one of the cavities quite well. But what is really promising is if you run a profile through the data, you can see that the pixels are actually picking out the right values. You see close to 1500 meters per second when we pass the water into the PVCP, we get about 1410, 1420, once again through water going up there and so on. So I would like to conclude by saying that we've concentrated on really transmitter development. We played with a lot of materials and approaches, and we've shown imaging on phantoms. We've also done a bit of in vivo work because David has two very nice papers in 2020, except that he's been using a linear array in this case. And the challenges are, of course, to tell your story in 7 minutes. But I think one of the biggest challenges is sparsity of transmitters, and the laser that we are using has a limited repetition rate. And that's my time, I think. Thank you.